Have any of you ever seen a ghost? It's not an experience that we have first-hand experience of, but it does make for some interesting scenarios. When someone dies, for example, could your mind play tricks as you are overcome with grief? Could hallucinations actually be documented ghost sightings? What the mind wants, the mind gets, right? In ancient Egypt, the return of a ghost was also considered a very serious matter. For the Egyptians, non-existence was an intolerable concept, and it was believed that, at death, the soul traveled to the Hall of Truth, where it was judged by Osiris and the 42 judges by having its heart weighed in balance with the white feather of truth. If the heart was found lighter than the feather, the soul proceeded on to the afterlife, while if it was heavier, it was thrown to the floor where it was eaten by a monster and the soul would cease to exist. The heart would be lighter if you have lived a good life and heavier if you had not. The afterlife was known as the Field of Reeds, which was a mirror image of life on earth in Egypt. You would enjoy the house you knew, the stream by the house, your favorite tree and dog, and so there was no reason for a soul to want to return to earth unless that soul had a very good reason for doing so. In the earlier period of Egypt, the soul was considered a single entity known as the Ku, the immortal aspect of an individual, but in later times the soul was thought to be comprised of five different components. Two of these components, the Ba and Ka, spirit and personality, came together after death in the form of the Ak, and it was this entity that would return as a ghost. If proper rites had not been observed in burial, or some sin had been committed by the living, either before or after the person's death, the Ak was given dispensation by the gods to return to earth to redress the wrong. The living who were harassed by the ghost would have to plead their case directly to the returned spirit in hopes of a reasonable response, and if that was ineffective, would need to have a priest intervene and judge between the living and the dead. If properly buried with adequate rites and continually remembered, the spirits of the dead could be a great benefit to the living and watch over them throughout their lives. There was a significant difference, however, in Egyptian understanding of a spirit who resides peacefully in the Field of Reeds and a ghost who returned to Earth. What do you guys think of this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.